there in France, in a big advance, little Dolly Dolly.
July 19th, 1870. The Second French Empire declared war on Prussia. Mobilized German forces, ready to fight, swiftly crossed the border and won two significant battles. The Battle of Wissembourg on 4th of August and the Battle of Spichern on 6th of August. Prussians gained initiative, which they used to push French forces relentlessly. Through August, 1st, 2nd and 3rd armies marched deeper into French territory, winning battle after battle, forcing French generals to retreat. 31st of August 1870. After the Battle of Beaumont, French Marshal and Chief of French Main Forces, Patrice MacMahon, ordered the last units to retreat to Sedan. Large city defended by two rivers from the south, west and the east, as well as border of Belgium in the north. His plan was to regroup his units in safe positions and then, possibly, march to the west, so he could keep Germans away from Paris. I wouldn't want to be in MacMahon's boots. Wherever he goes, he will be in our range. We can pursue him from one place to another like hunting a prey, until he's forced to go where we want him to. He lost the right wing and he has to go at our front. Even when he doesn't, he will be stopped by Crown Prince, and one way or another, we will get him. Newly formed French Chalon's army, consisting of 202 infantry battalions, 80 squadrons of cavalry and 564 cannons, quickly has been surrounded by German forces. Prussian 1st Army held the right wing, while Bavarian 3rd Army cut French supplies from the west. Otto von Bismarck made sure to threaten the Belgians that if they allowed French forces to move into their territory to consolidate, that Prussia would attack Belgium as well. So French army has been also cut from the north. Besides, Saxon guards and Prussian cavalry surrounded Sedan from the north. Encirclement of Sedan has been completed. The French realized what just happened, so sappers have been sent to blow up the bridge on the Meuse River in Donchery, so Prussians won't be able to send supplies and units between river banks. Unfortunately for the French, sappers have been stopped by Prussian riflemen. Now we got them in a mousetrap. On the evening of the 31st of August, soldiers of 11th Corps cut the last remaining French railway. Prussians, who found French supply trains left in Donchery, were celebrating with champagne, while in Fresnes, privates built a stage for the King Wilhelm, Bismarck, Moltke, German princes, military attachés and journalists, so they could witness the battle on the next day. MacMahon made a terrible mistake. One of his generals, Auguste Alexandre Duclos, said, "We are in a chamber pot, and we are going to be shipped." September 1st, 1870, 400 hours. Bavarian 1st Corps advances through a railway bridge in Basilea. General Ludwig von der Than attacked faster than he was supposed to. French resistance in the city decimated the Bavarians. French General Barthélemy Lebrun sent his 12th Corps to retake the city with artillery assistance. On the east side of the city, 1st Corps counterattacked Germans to stop them from reaching the Bavarian army. MacMahon, who witnessed that clash, has been wounded in the legs by artillery grenade, so he appointed Ducrot to lead the French forces in the upcoming Battle of Sedan. German 5th and 11th Corps took Flers and Felinet. French general staff, after Ducrot took charge, was consumed by infighting. Emmanuel Wimpfen, high-ranking French general, refused to take orders from Ducrot. While Ducreux decided to make a breakthrough in the west to escape with his units from Sedan, Wimpfen ordered to defend the city. So, in the late morning, the battle started. German Krupp guns had an amazing range for the times, so French soldiers were attacked from every side as well as from the above. At noon, Bavarians took Basilea and approached Sedan. Their artillery quickly joined the Prussian cannons in bombardment of the city. Prussians fired 20,000 artillery shells on that day. German infantry advanced slowly, stealing food and alcohols on the way, while Wipfen backed Napoleon III, Caesar of France, who also had been stuck in the city of Sedan, to lead the army through Bala and Basilea. Prussians took Calvardy. Wipfen's soldiers retook Balan at 1 p.m. Fortress of Sedan was still holding, but King Wilhelm, who just have been informed that Napoleon III is in the city, ordered every cannon to bombard the fort. Almost every French soldier is now fleeing towards the city center, while avoiding artillery fire from all sides. Ducreux ordered mounted riflemen to retake Flory. Germans, however, had 144 cannons ready for counterattack. No French horsemen arrived at Flo. French army corpses were breaking up one after another. Some units fled to the city center, while some tried to make defensive positions in the forest outside of the city. German artillery, however, forced Frenchmen to flee from that position as well. In late afternoon came the end of the battle. Last units of General Wipfen showed the Germans a white flag. French forces lost 3,000 dead, 14,000 wounded, and 21,000 prisoners, while German lost 9,000 dead, wounded, and captured in total. Remaining forces in Sedan had to surrender, so the total number of prisoners taken by the Prussians totals to over 80,000. Napoleon III, as well as many French generals, were captured. Battle of Sedan was an end of an era. New German military doctrines made Napoleonic style of warfare obsolete. This encirclement was a major turning point which led to Prussian victory in Franco Prussian War. In 1895, on 25th anniversary of the battle, special clasp for the Franco Prussian War medal has been made to award German participants of that battle. Here you can see two of such clasps. Thank you for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe as it helps my channel a lot. Every medal shown comes from my private collection and there are more videos to come.